In donut business, taste and quality is king. If you miss the taste, if you miss the quality, there is no business. So in this video, I'm going to share with you how you can start a donut business successfully. Stick to the end of this video and you will never regret it. But before we begin, I want you to do this for me. In donut business, you will need a mixer, a blender. You will also need some pans and frying pans that you will use. You will need tables and other things that will aid the production of donuts so that your product will look smooth and beautiful. So gather these equipment, get ready for production. Form two teams, those that will be in the factory with you and those that will be out there to sell the product. Now, the first team that will be in the factory with you should be smart, decent, and very careful. Now, one principle I will tell you is that any of them that is not working according to the rules, any of them that is not decent, that is not mindful of what he or she is doing, should be sacked immediately. Because in donut business, you must avoid mistakes. And then your sales team must be those that are not ready to take no for an answer, those that are ready to visit shops of different types, those that are ready to approach buyers, possible buyers, those that are ready to open new channels for you. You must equip them, you must pay them well, you must make them to feel that they belong, you know, because without sales, there will be no business. So you need a very strong and a matured sales team that will help you push the product out there. A sales team, for instance, when I started, I had very good three boys that were ready to sell 5 bags a day. They were ready. When production is completed, the product will be out immediately and they will come home empty just with the money. And the business was growing rapidly because those guys were rugged in terms of sales. So sales matters a lot too. When you form the production team, also build a good marketing team. In production, taste and quality is king, just as I said earlier. So for you to have the best taste, the best quality, you must also learn to apply the 3-2-4 rule. What do I mean by that? The 2-3-4 rule is a combination of flavors to give you your own outstanding and unique flavor. Go to the market and buy not less than 10 kinds of flavors. Buy also garlic, buy your onions, buy other spices that you know that can bring flavor in any food. Buy at least a custard of flour and then carry out this experiment by yourself. Combine 2 or 3, test it and see if the taste is good, the flavor, the aroma is good, then you can use that. Now, if you combine the first two, it does not work. Combine another one, it does not work. Combine another one, mix 2 or 3, mix this, mix that. When you bring them at the end, you will see the best combination for you that no one else have. So when you get that quality, when you get that flavor mixed, when you get your own pattern of combination, then you are ready to take over the market, irrespective of the big guys who are there already, you know, making money or making waves, those that their business are known, you will break it and go in. Business location is very, very important. It can make or break your business. So you need to sit down or after forming the team, let them decide with you where to locate this business. If you are in one of the interior places in Nigeria or wherever you come from, then what you need to do is to build a good team, and you need to buy maybe bikes or a car that will take this product from that locality out to where the customers are. But if you cannot do that, then you need to look for a very good and conducive location that can easily be accessed by customers. If you fail to follow this, you will lose it. You will regret it. Number one is never you send out any product that has any error. If there is any mistake, please don't send it out, irrespective of the amount you have put in. That is why your production team must be decent and disciplined, ready to work, to deliver. They must have this at the back of their mind, that any mistake, maybe sand or the salt is not enough, the sugar is not enough, the flavor was not enough, whatever mistake that occurred. If you want to maintain your growth, then you must avoid sending out any product that has any error. Number two warning is avoid careless workers by sending out or sacking immediately anyone that is reckless and is not ready to follow the rules that are laid in the factory. If you fail to sack, others will imitate, or he will cause more damage. So immediately, when once you notice any worker that is careless, reckless, or dirty, send that person out. There should be no sympathy in this. You should not use your business for sympathy. So you must make sure that any worker that is not following the rules should go out. So start your business with whatever you have. I tell you that it will grow. I started with half bag. In a period of 1 year, we were already producing up to 5 bags based on the rarity of marketers and the quality of the product. These two things helped us a lot, and we were making money. Everyone was smiling home. So if you want to smile home and enjoy your business, I want you to follow these rules and guidelines, these tips that I share with you, and you will never regret it. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe and click on the notification bell. That way, whenever we release awesome videos like this, you will be a partaker.